veins of the upper limb. Venous drainage of the upper limb can be classified in by deep fascia. The vein, superficial to the deep fascia or deep to the deep fascia? There are veins, superficial to the deep fascia, under the skin, in the superficial fascia, called superficial veins, which are larger and more important. Deep to the deep fascia, there are deep veins. Therefore, the veins of the upper limb is classified by deep fascia and superficial veins in the subcutaneous tissue, in the superficial fascia, and deep veins deep to the deep fascia. The superficial veins, which are more important, every one of you, look for the dorsal aspect of the hand. You will find this. The superficial veins of the upper limb start on the dorsal of the hand by this vein. This vein is straight or arched?
Arched.
On the dorsal aspect. Where superficial vein to get? Therefore, this vein is called superficial dorsal. The dorsal aspect of the hand. Venous arch. Superficial dorsal venous arch. Which receive veins from? Achilles veins from?
Fingers.
Dorsum of the hand. And palm of the hand. Palm of the hand is that. So that works. Let me explain about the whole palm of the hand. Piercing the intermuscular spaces and piercing the intermuscular to drain into the dorsal venous arch. Therefore, the dorsal venous arch draining the fingers, dorsum of the hand, and the grip restraint the palm of the hand by veins piercing the intermuscular and the intermuscular spaces to drain into the superficial dorsal venous arch. The superficial dorsal venous arch continue laterally or medially? Both. Continues laterally to form cephalic vein. And continue medially to form basilic vein.
Medial to the brachial artery.
What is the cephalic and basilic vein? Start with cephalic. It begins as continuation of the medial part of dorsal venous arch. Begins at this famous area, which is it starts at the roof of the anatomical stump box. Ascend down. This is a dorsal view. Okay? Ascend down and turn forward. This is the anterior view. The cephalic vein starts as confirmation of the lateral end of the dorsal venous arch. In the roof of the anatomical stump box, then ascend above the wrist, then curve around the lateral border to reach the front of the forearm. It runs along the lateral aspect of the front of the forearm. Lateral aspect of front of forearm. And it's somehow in the lateral. Enter this fossa. This famous fossa in front of the elbow is called enter the lateral aspect and the passing in the lateral aspect of the roof of human devotion. They ascend upward. Ascend upward along the lateral border of biceps muscle. الحفرة دي كده اول حاسس على اللاترال بوردر اوف بايسس تحتك على طول سيفاليك جيم. السند ابل ان ذا ارم تو ريتش ذيس فيموس جروف بتوين ذيس لارج ماسل which is called deltoid and the muscle here from the chest which is called pectoralis. The group between pectoralis major and deltoid is called deltopectoral groove. The cephalic vein runs in the deltopectoral groove and piercing the deep fascia to enter the axilla to end in axillary vein. Then, lateral contraction of dorsal venous arch begins at the roof of the abdomen sandbox. Ascend above the wrist, very short distance back on the back of the forearm. Then appear on the front of the forearm. Ascend on the lateral aspect of the front of the forearm. Passing in the roof, on the lateral aspect of the roof, the cubital fossa. Ascend along the lateral border of biceps. Pass in the deltopectoral groove. Piercing the deep fascia to enter the axilla. To end in axillary vein. This is the spheric vein. What about basilic vein? The basilic vein start as a continuation of the medial end of superficial dorsal venous arch. From the medial aspect, it ascends along the back of the forearm. بس مش back area. Along the posteromedial aspect. هو بصير اه بس على medial aspect. Ascend along the posteromedial aspect of the forearm. بس هيروح فين؟ هيظهر لازم على الفرانت. Appear on the front of the forearm just above the elbow. Just below the elbow. Appear in the front of the forearm. Here. Just below the elbow. This is the basilic vein. Appear in the front of the forearm just below the elbow. Crossing the roof of the cubital fossa in the medial part of the roof of the cubital fossa. Ascend upward in the arm to pierce the deep fascia at the level of the middle of the arm. Pierce the deep fascia in the middle of the arm, يعني دخل في العمق بقى. دخل في العمق حيث هيكون ماشي ميديال تو ذيس هارت. What is the artery in the middle of the heart? Passing medial to the brachial artery. Ascend medial to the brachial artery until the level of the famous level. Lower border of teres major. The basilic vein unite with the vena cubitans of brachial at the lower border of teres major to form axillary vein. We all know that the axillary vein ascend upward medial to axillary heart to end where the axillary vein. What you say? Axillary vein begins because the venous range comes from below at the level of the lower border of teres major and the vein ascend up to end where? Outer border of first rib by entering the root of the neck as subclavian vein. طبعا تكير that the venous drainage is the reverse of arterial sublime. Axillary artery begins at the outer border of first rib, descend downward to end at the lower border of tris major. But the case that the venous return comes from below. Therefore, the axillary vein begins at lower border of tris major, which is the end of the artery. Ascend upward to end at the outer border of first rib, which is the beginning of the artery. Okay, the venous drainage is the reverse of arterial sublime. The artery begins here and ends here. The reverse, the vein from below begins here and ends here. Between the basilic vein in the cubital fossa and the spheric vein in the cubital fossa, a vein passing in between. In between. The nos, yeah? The nos. In the middle. Therefore, this vein is called median. And in the cubital fossa, median cubital vein. Here is an important diagram you mentioned before. Median cubital vein passing superficial to bicipital abdominis. Bicipital abdominis here, medial cubital vein here. D to the bicipital abdominis. There are what?
There is your beginning.
Lower part of brachial artery and the median nerve. يعني واحد أحوال داخل الجوانب يعمل فينوس انجكشن غلط في الميديان كيوبتال فين ممكن يعمل انجري اندر لاين بريكيال ارتري اور ميديان is a very important applied anatomy for the nurses. لا طبعا مش معقول يقع في الغلطه دي دكتور. فالبيجيننج بيجنرز كلاود اوف ذا نيرسز ممكن واحنا كده لسه متخرجه ولا في مدرسه التمريض بتتعلم يمكن. لكن دكتور يعملها بتبقى فضيحه بجلال. ماشي. Finally the last superficial vein is this vein. Vein start at the flexor tram. By fusion of multiple small vulnar veins. Small superficial vulnar veins unite together, superficial to the flexor tram. This vein ascend in the middle of the forearm. Therefore, it's called median vein of the forearm. The median vein of the forearm ascend in the middle of the front of the forearm, just below the cubital fossa. This is divided into two veins. Median basilic vein joins the basilic vein. And the median cephalic vein joins the cephalic vein. These are the superficial veins of the upper limb. Mainly cephalic, basilic, median cubital vein, median vein of the forearm. What about the deep veins? The deep veins actually, which are the deep fascia? Deep to the deep fascia. The veins deep to the deep fascia are actually the vena cumitans of large arteries. Large arteries, radial, and brachial are accompanied on both sides by vein to the right and vein to the left. Therefore, each large artery accompanied usually by two anastomosing veins. I mean, anastomosing my brother. The vena cumitans of radial and ulnar continuous above as vena cumitans of brachial and the vena cumitans of brachial. No, this is the vena cumitans of brachial. They use at the lower border of Terrace Main with basilic vein to form the axillary vein. Okay? This is the venous drainage of the upper level.